Welcome, welcome today to this video where we are going to focus on hedge trimmers. And there are a whole range of options when it comes to these tools, as well as plenty of considerations you should make before buying. To the casual observer, a hedge trimmer might just seem a hedge trimmer, but as you well know, you come across all sorts of hedges, and these tools need to cover many different applications. So let's dive in to the world of fascinating battery hedge trimmers with a couple of comparisons to their combustion engine counterparts. Oh, and of course, we will endeavor to answer your questions along the way. Thanks for stopping by. I'm your host, Matt, and I'm joined today by Paul from STIHL Product Management. He's going to tell us everything we need to know about hedge trimmers. Welcome back, Paul. Nice to be working together again with you, sir.
Thank you very much. I'm looking forward to talking about our hedge trimmers here today. Thank you.
I'm looking forward to it too. Let's dive right in. You and your colleagues have done a lot of research into hedge trimmers. When it comes to developing the perfect trimmer, what's important?
Well, two things really. The first thing, it needs to take care of the user. So they need to be a really high performance machine that gets the job done. So you need to have enough power to complete your tasks whilst being really simple and easy to use. So a really good performance machine for the user, but also taking care of nature. So if you're coming up to a large overgrown hedge or beautiful shaped topiary, it has to take care of all these different tasks and leave the hedge in great condition as well.
Exactly.
So a really nice, neat, smooth cut through the branches or the foliage is really important, as you don't want to introduce any disease to the plant. So looking after the user and looking after the plant health is absolutely paramount.
I like it. It's that synergy, isn't it, of exactly. Nature and user. Okay, so how do you pull it off at STIHL then?
Well, I'll get a machine down and we'll talk through it here.
Yeah.
So with this HSA 130, it's not just about having sharp cutters. Sharp cutters are part of it, but it's part of a bigger picture, really. So it's down to the sharp cutters, but really nice cutter geometry. So on here, these cutters need to hold their edge for a long time because you don't want to be going a short time and then have to sharpen your cutters again. So
sure,
holding that sharp edge for a long time is really important.
Can I jump in there? What do you mean by geometry?
You have to have a nice geometry on the cutter so it cuts the branches really nice and cleanly and stops any diseases being introduced to the plant.
Okay.
Then moving back through the machine, it's combining that cutter geometry and sharp cutters with an EC motor, electric motor, within the tool, a really well-designed gearbox and good gearing on there, and overall just being really nice and easy to handle.
So what interests me is that when I'm out and about, I notice there seem to be different types of hedges, right? Sometimes you see really beautifully, almost designed works of art, you could say, very sort of detailed work. And then there are other hedges that seem to serve a purpose. Maybe it's, I don't know, keeping light out or keeping sound out, something like that. And it seems that there are different hedges for different purposes, right?
Yeah, absolutely. There's a huge variety of hedges. So we've got a wide variety of machines to help tackle those tasks, whether right. It's a big, tall hedge or a smaller hedge. So we've got handheld hedge trimmers, and we've also got long-reach hedge trimmers, like you can see just behind me here. So something for every application, whether it's a big overgrown hedge, an annual cut, or really smart topiary. So something for everything. We've got a little video from Ben, who's an arborist and a landscaper in the city of Waiblingen, where STIHL are headquartered.
Yes.
So we'll have a look at him using a tool in action.
Okay, here we go.
Hi, I'm Benjamin, 21 years old, and I work for the city of Waiblingen in the field of tree care. At the moment, we are pruning hedges. The HSA 130R is the ideal hedge trimmer for this. The HSA 130R is powerful and has wide tooth spacing. This allows us to cut thicker branches. In summer, we use a trimming version of the hedge trimmer because it is ideal for shaping as it offers a fine cut. Battery-powered devices are generally a nicer tool for us to use, as the noise pollution for us and the neighbours is not so high. Battery-powered appliances are also much easier to start than petrol-powered ones. Let's get started.
Very nice indeed, Ben. Good job, particularly considering the slightly windy weather there. So he was working with a 130R, but he also talked about a different machine there, right?
He did, yes. He mentioned the HSA 130T. So if you get the T version down, I'll talk you through both.
Right. Take that off.
So first of all, we've got the HSA-130R, which Ben was using. Now this has a wider cutter spacing of 38 millimetres and a slower stroke rate on the cutters of 3,200 RPM. So
okay,
that means,
why slower?
Well, that means you can get the branch material into the cutters, so it'll be cut nice and neatly. So the slower speed and the wider cutters are good for overgrown hedges. So often you turn up to a hedge, you don't know what you're cutting or how long since it's been cut, and it can have tougher material. So that's a really good machine to be able to tackle the more demanding tasks.
Very nice.
And then we have the T version here as well. So T stands for trim.
Good.
This actually has a smaller tooth spacing of 30 millimetres, but a faster stroke rate of around 5,000 RPM.
Right.
So the faster cutters combined with the smaller tooth spacing gives a really, really neat finish to the hedge. So it's ideal for topiary or beautiful box or yew hedging.
That would be those forming design works that we were talking about earlier, right?
Exactly. There's a lot of beautiful hedges in the world, or absolute sculptures, where you have to have a really nice, neat finish to the hedge to keep its beautiful form. So the trim version is definitely recommended.
R for rough, T for trim. There's another one over there, right?
Yep, exactly. Here we have the HSA-100, which sits beneath the HSA-130, as the model name depicts. We've actually got a battery slot in this tool, so you can choose to put the battery in the tool rather than connecting via the umbilical power cord there.
Sure.
It has a slower blade speed of around 3,000 RPM and a 34 millimetre cutter spacing.
Okay.
So that's a good master of all hedges, and it's something that's very, very versatile. Often you don't really know what you're turning up to, so it's a good do-it-all machine.
Very nice, very nice. And then there's this beast over here, which I will bring down.
Yep,
This is a different size altogether, right?
Yes, so that's the HLA-135 long reach hedge trimmer. So this enables you to actually reach really tall hedges from the comfort of the ground. If you're stood safely on the ground, it's a lot easier and safer than being on a platform.
No need for a ladder, right?
Exactly. We don't recommend using the hedge trimmers up a ladder. It's always good to be either on the ground or on a safe platform. So that allows you to reach the much taller hedges from the safety and ease of the ground as well, and you don't need to move a platform side to side to side. You can just walk along the ground and do that.
Brilliant.
But we do actually have a different version of that, the HLA-86, which I'll talk about in a moment. First, we'll see Ben using the HLA-135.
Let's do that. Okay, then talk us through what he's doing then here.
So first of all, he's checking out his hedge. You've got a 145 degree angled gear head on there. So you can adjust the cutters to suit the hedge you're tackling, whether it be the sides of the hedge or the tops of the hedge. So of course he's popping in his battery, fully charged there, attaching it to his extreme harness to take a bit of a weight out of the tool. And you'll notice he's angled it slightly so he can stand back from the hedge and he hasn't got his face right in.
Yeah.
And that gives him a clean line of sight to make sure he gets a nice, neat, straight hedge, as we don't want wonky hedges. So it allows you to do that and then angle the head over to cut neatly along the top.
Very nice indeed.
Exactly.
Good job.
Yeah, so that's the HLA-135, and for taller hedges we have got the HLA-86, which sits just beneath it in the range in terms of power, but it's telescopic. It can reach 3.3 metres in tool length, so add that onto your height and your reach.
That's a pretty big hedge you're cutting there, isn't it?
You can reach some very, very, very tall hedges very, very simply and easily.
Okay, so we've certainly seen that there are a multitude of different devices for the different situations. I'm still curious though, maybe to draw a comparison between the battery-powered hedge trimmers and their combustion brothers and sisters. And as I understand, you've conducted some tests, right?
Yep, to answer that, we'll take a little look at a comparison test that we've set up. So,
what's happening here?
In this video, you can see the HS82R petrol combustion engine powered machine going through increasing sizes of beech sticks.
And they would represent branches, right?
Exactly that.
So they're getting thicker and thicker. Okay, the work's getting slower, but we're still coming through.
And here we see it get to the fourth from last stick. And then now we can take a little look at the HSA 130R doing the exact same test here. So we go and take a quick look at that video.
So I'm genuinely intrigued. So remember, the petrol-powered tool got to the fourth last thickness of stick, right?
Exactly, and then we've got the same cutters actually, whether it's a different power head, one's powered by battery, one's powered by petrol, but it's the same cutting attachment.
And apart from that, the test setup was the same, right?
Yeah, same day, same operator, and same diameter sticks, and it's getting to the same...
And wouldn't you know it?
Same situation. It's got from the fourth to last on the test there. So what we can really say is actually we've got comparable performance, whether you've got a petrol or combustion engine device,
yeah,
or a battery powered device. So in the STIHL range, whether you're turning up to a tough overgrown hedge with a handheld device, you've got enough power to get through that task. And if you've got a tall overgrown hedge as well, equally you've got the long reach models in the range as well. So something for every task to make sure you can tackle it all with ease.
You certainly do. Options, options, options. Many thanks, Paul, for now. Our question to you, what kind of experience have you made with STIHL battery-powered hedge trimmers? Let us know in the comments below. And of course, if you've got any questions, then fire them over and I'll get Paul and his colleague here to answer them for you. Oh, and if you're particularly interested in learning more about STIHL battery technology, then check out this video right here. That'll tell you everything you need to know. Okay, so we've certainly learned about the power of these beauties. Why don't we move on to the subject of user-friendliness?
Oh, well, there's certainly some advantages to moving to battery-powered devices, particularly the hedge trimmers. So if you're trimming hedges for a long period of time, often if you're standing next to the hedge, there's nowhere for the exhaust emissions to go. Right. So moving to battery-powered devices, there's no emissions at the operator level. So it makes it much more pleasant when you're using the tools.
Good point.
Also, they're a lot quieter. So if you're working around schools or hospitals or hotels, then it's much better for the passers-by or the people in school able to listen to their lessons rather than listening to a hedge trimmer outside.
So yeah, that's, less sound pollution, yeah.
Exactly, so it's better for the people, the operators as well, so they don't always have to listen to a louder machine.
Or you wouldn't have to wear ear protection as much?
With some models you don't, with some you do. But okay. It's certainly a lot more comfortable for the operator.
Mm-hmm.
But then in terms of maintenance, the battery machines are a lot less complex. So in the motor side of the machine, you've got an EC motor, you've got an electronic control module and a battery, which is simpler overall than a combustion engine where you've got a piston and cylinder, spark plug, fuel filter, air filter, and more things to maintain, as well as having to get the right fuel mix. So we do know some accidents can happen. You can accidentally put straight fuel in a machine which would seize the engine, but the worst thing that can happen with a battery device is you forget to charge the battery, and that's pretty easily resolved on a fast charger.
Got it, makes total sense. What about the whole startup process? Because that's different as well, isn't it?
Yeah, overall it's a little bit simpler on the battery-powered machines, but we've got a couple of videos to take a look at now. First, the petrol machine.
Okay, what's the process here?
So here he's priming the bulb there, just making sure the fuel's in the system. He's then going to move the choke onto full choke,
mm-hmm,
pull the starter cord until it splutters and almost comes into life, pop it into semi-choke and pull the machine over until it starts. So you're ready to go there.
So it's a process I think we've all seen and done before, but it does take a couple of seconds.
Yep, it's a simple enough process, but it does take a few stages to get there. Whereas on the battery machine here, we're just plugging in the cord or popping in the battery, activating the switch here to make it live and then pulling the trigger. So it's very simple to pick up and go with a battery machine.
And you're ready to go right after that. Okay, so that's the user standing at the hedge. What about the things that the user actually holds and touches? So there is a small display here. There are knobs and switches. Talk me through that.
Well, they're all designed to be really friendly for the user. So starting up here, we've got the handle, the front handle, the switch all the way around it. So no matter which way you're holding it, you can activate the front switch.
Gravity's always helping you, isn't it?
And yeah, exactly. The gravity's activating the switch for you, so you're not putting any effort into that. Then as you move back through the machine, you've got a really easy to use multifunction handle here. You've got three stages for the RPMs, which we talked about earlier, and you've actually got a rotating handle. So if I'm going down the side of a hedge, I'm easily pulling the front trigger, and my wrist is really comfortable for me to sweep up the hedge and trim it nice and neatly. Then if I wanted to move to the tops of the hedge, I move the handle round, and that's comfortable again for me to trim the tops nice and simply.
If I may say so, Paul, you've definitely got the moves.
Thank you.
Very smooth. Okay, so when I'm working in my garden, something that really bugs me is when it gets, when the hedge trimmer gets stuck on something, you know, and I'm stuck there and I'm jammed and I can't get it out and it's just connected to the hedge.
Yeah, well, we've got something to help with that, that's
for
sure.
I've heard, yes.
So we've got an anti-stuck manoeuvre. So if you're going through a hedge that's a little tougher than you expected, perhaps it's more than annual growth, and there are some branches in there that are a bit thicker than you should be really going through with a hedge trimmer, maybe perhaps suited more to a chainsaw, we've got a nice manoeuvre we've got a little video of to show. So we can take a little look at that now. We've asked Ben to get a bit enthusiastic and get the machine stuck. When you lift off the switch and then start the machine again, the blades move in the opposite direction. So as they were moving in and getting stuck, they, when you started again, move away from the branch and you and pull the hedge trimmer away and get on with your job.
Very clever indeed. I could definitely do with that in my garden. Another question that would interest me would be the ergonomics and the general comfort, particularly when you're working for maybe a couple of hours at a hedge. Can we investigate that subject?
Yeah, absolutely. So carrying a hedge trimmer for a long period of time, it's more comfortable to try and take the weight away from the hedge trimmer,
right,
and actually maybe perhaps put it somewhere else instead.
Yes.
So we'll put a battery, we'll get a battery out and put this harness on.
Okay.
So if you put
Put that on.
So this is our belt carrying system with a shoulder harness there as well. You've got your hip belt there as well. I'm putting in the battery, which is now operational, and I'm securing it in place.
I've got my umbilical cord here.
And you just plug that in, align the two arrows there, and you're ready to go and operational.
I'm good to go. Rock and roll. Very nice. If you'd unplug that for me, please. Okay, so let's now finish where we started, and that's on the subject of STIHL quality again. What can you tell me, last couple of bits of information about the quality craftsmanship on these devices?
Well, there's a lot that goes into a hedge trimmer. So starting at the cutting attachment end, we've got hardened STIHL blades, which go through a heat treatment to make them last as long as possible. We've also got double-sided, which are cutters on the top and the bottom, and double-edged blades. So each blade has an opposing cutter for a really nice, neat finish. We've also got a tip protector at the top end. So if you're working along walls or against the ground, it protects the cutters from any damage if you're accidentally knocking against the floor or a wall.
So very handy.
Indeed. Further up the cutters, we've got cut protection. So if you were to come in contact with your leg, it will protect you with the cut protection on there as well. We've got an anti-vibration system on the front handle, so it just keeps your vibration levels nice and low.
Oh, okay, reduces the vibrations in your hand.
Yeah, makes it comfortable to use for long periods of time.
Mm-hmm.
Then underneath, we've got the magnesium cover on the gearbox, so we still actually make our own magnesium housings in-house. We have been doing for many, many years on our combustion machines, making all their componentry, and we're doing the same for our battery-powered machines. You can see a nice little easy access grease port, so if you do need to top up the grease in the gearbox, you can do that really simply and easily just under there. And then, of course, we've got a high-quality EC motor on there that gives you a variable trigger, and that motor and the electronics inside can actually call up extra power. So if you're going through a tougher part of a hedge, it can temporarily put a little bit of extra power into the motor just to help you get through that little tougher task.
So very interesting indeed.
A lot goes into them, that's for sure.
It certainly does. And as you had your hand here, just here, it made me think of this black circle here. I've always asked myself what that is.
Yes, that's the Smart Connector 2A. So a second generation of our fleet management system. So this one actually plugs into the module of the tool. So it's got a real-time clock and can tell you how long the machine's been used for and when it was used as well. So not only can check on the usage of your tool fleet and what machines are being used, what machines are perhaps not being used, but also book in maintenance. So it'll automatically tell me when I need to check the basic operations of my controls, or perhaps when I need to put some grease into the gearbox. So it'll automatically prompt me through the STIHL Connected app and through the STIHL Connected portal on the PC and tell me what maintenance I need to do on my machine. So it's fleet management made that little bit simpler by telling you what you've got to do and when.
Absolutely right. All the important data, you could say.
Exactly.
And that's exactly what you've given us today. All the important data to the hedge trimmers. Thank you so much, Paul, mate. I really, really appreciate that. Hopefully we'll do this again.
Absolutely.
I'd enjoy it very much, and hopefully we'll do this again. We hope that you enjoy stopping by and checking out about the STIHL battery-powered hedge trimmers. Obviously, leave any comments or questions that you've got down here in the comments section. And of course, don't forget to click that subscription button and ring the bell so that you can get notified anytime that we've got new content for you. But one final time from all of us here in the workshop, thanks for being part of this today. Take care of yourselves, and bye-bye.